Hey friends, it's Scott Hanselman and it's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm continuing my in-depth look at the Azure Maps APIs, and here I've got Ricky Brundritt, and we're going to talk about the Directions API and what you can do with routing.
Yes, so the Azure Maps platform, we have a REST service which does direction API, and it allows you to calculate directions either for car, truck, taxi, walking, and several other modes of transportation as well. But it also allows you to do it between multiple waypoints. So, you know, typically we'd go from point A to point B, but we allow up to 50 waypoints. So you can go from point A to point B all the way up to point AX.
Wow, that makes a lot of sense because, you know, ordinarily when you use, you know, a public map, I think about I'm either walking or I'm on the train or I'm driving.
Right.
But if I'm going to be doing an enterprise application, I might be running a fleet, I might have to do all kinds of complicated routing to make sure that I do the most efficient thing. So it makes sense that I would have that kind of control.
Exactly. And to even go more into that, we also support the waypoint optimization. So you might put your waypoints in A, B, C, D, but that might not be the most efficient way to go between them. And so you can use the traveling salesman algorithm, which we know from university. It's already built in. You just simply say, optimize my waypoints, and it'll do it for you.
And then Azure Maps and the APIs handle it for me.
Yes.
Very cool. And you have some demos for me.
Yes, and so one other thing that's pretty neat is you can also calculate routes based on your combustion or electric efficiency.
No way.
So if you have an electric car, you can put in how much, you know, kilojoules you have left in your car.
Right.
And it'll try to give you the best route for that so that you can make it to your destination.
That's interesting, and that's a really complicated stuff. I mean, there's a lot of things that one could potentially, I don't know if Azure Maps does this, but when you're thinking about efficiency, there's the wind direction at the time, and there's topography, you know, am I going up hills or downhill, and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, you can also take into consideration departure and arrival time, so if you need to be at a place for a certain time, you can put that into the request, and it'll say, okay, you need to leave by this time, and if you need to, you know, or if you're departing at a certain time, it'll tell you approximately when you'll arrive. It uses traffic data for that to make sure that, you know, it'll use real-time traffic data if you do the calculation right now.
Right.
It also uses historical traffic if you put in a previous date. And if you put in a future date, it'll actually use predictive using that historical data.
Wow. Mm-hmm. That's pretty cool. And what's great about this, of course, is that this all lives in my Azure account. I can sign up and set up Azure Maps in the Azure portal, and I can put this into my applications today.
Yes, exactly.
What do you got to show me?
So this was just a brief overview of some of the things we just talked about. But what also I wanted to highlight was we have routing and the Directions API is available in 116 countries around the globe.
Wow. That is a lot. Almost all of them. That's great.
Yeah. It's a pretty good coverage there. So now I want to jump into a demo here on just taking a look at a simple REST request. So we look in here in Postman, and we have our simple URL going put into the service. You know, we want a JSON request, and you know, we're using the version 1 of the API. You pass in your subscription key, which is that jumbled up string there. And then your query. So your query is your waypoints. And so in this case here, we're using coordinates that are colon delimited.
Okay.
And so we have two coordinates in this request. I've also requested that the polyline, so the route path, be returned so that we can use it for rendering later.
Oh, nice. Okay.
And then I've also specified my travel mode, which in this case is set to car.
And I assume that even though I'm passing in latitude and longitude from point A to point B, I could pass in other points and things like that.
Correct.
Okay.
And so if we just take a quick look at the response, it comes back. And one of the first things you see is the summary, and it provides us some pretty useful information. The first one being the actual length of the route in meters, and also the travel time in seconds. It also tells us the traffic delay in seconds as well. So, you know, how much of that time, of that travel time is due to traffic. We also see the departure time and the arrival time that are estimated based on when you made the request. And then if we jump in further, we can also see all the coordinates that make up that route path.
Okay, so those are the points that make the polyline that it returned?
Correct.
Very cool.
And
I can render that, like you said, however I want to.
Yes, you have full control over how it's rendered. And then if we take a look at this other request, so this request here is the same request with one minor addition as we added the request to add a return instructions. So by default, we'll return the line, but you can return their instructions in a lot of different ways. You can get the just a readable text, which is human readable. You can get it returned in a coded format, which is better for programmatic understanding of the, so if you want to do turn by turn.
Yep.
And then there's also the ability to have an enhanced text version, essentially, which will have some XML markup around certain keywords, so that if you wanted to go through and maybe highlight it and things like that.
Or text to voice.
Yep.
Yeah. So instruction types text, that means like turn left on Main Street and things
Correct.
Like that.
Right, and so yeah, so the same request that we just did before, but now with the instructions being returned, if we scroll down here, we'll see that.
Did you send that one?
Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, keep right. Yeah, look at that. It's just plain English.
Yeah, it's just plain English, easy to understand. Gives us a lot of useful information, like okay, what's the actual street name? Any signpost information? What kind of junction type is it? So this is a bifurcation, which is essentially the intersection of two highways.
Yeah, yeah.
And then other information like, all right, keep right, you know, and things like that. So real, real simple thing.
It's cool as, for myself, as someone, of course, uses GPS instructions all the time. There's also hidden information that I wish they would tell me that I could then add to my application. Turn angle in degrees. It's a 45 degree angle.
Right.
In the bifurcation where the street is going to split into two. There's a lot of cool stuff that I could integrate into my app if I chose to.
Exactly. So moving on, I wanted to show a couple of, looking at JSON's great, but it's better to look at the actual routes on a map.
Absolutely.
So this example here shows car versus truck routing. Mm-hmm. Trucks can't go everywhere that a car can go, and for various reasons. There's the size of the truck. It can't make tight turns. Mm-hmm. Can't go under low bridges. Sometimes trucks are carrying hazardous materials, and they can't go in certain places like tunnels.
Yeah.
So let's take a quick look at a couple examples. So this one example here, the red line indicates where a car would normally go, which is a nice short path and direct path. But the green line indicates the route the truck has to go. And the main reason for the difference is right here at Boyer or at this intersection here. Mm-hmm. There's actually a low bridge, mm-hmm. and then similarly, if we take a look at this route here. Again, we see the red line being the car route and the green one being the truck route. And this little intersection right there is a really tight turn, so too tight for the truck to turn.
Which is funny that you mention all of this because, just on Twitter a couple of days ago, there was a picture of a truck trying to go underneath an overpass, and it took the entire sheared off the top, and it dropped like soybeans all over the
Exactly.
This is why we need this kind of good information in our commercial applications.
Yeah, and this happens daily where, trucks are just taking the same routes as a car, and if they used a service like this, they would know ahead of time that they need to take a different route.
Yeah.
One other really interesting one is flammable load. So maybe you're driving a taco truck, and you got some really spicy goods in there, so it's really flammable. So you can't go through the Liberty Tunnel.
Clearly not. We should never take tacos through the Liberty Tunnel.
Yeah, and same thing with the I-90 here in Seattle. You can't take flammable goods on there as well. And we look at the Liberty Tunnel here. We can see that you have to take a route that's nearly twice as long to get to your destination.
Oh, wow. But that kind of stuff really matters, and that's important. Mm-hmm. Why the fact that this is available, that Azure Maps is available as an API that's built into the Azure portal for developers to go and integrate into their fleet management applications or their enterprise apps.
Hey, so the next demo I wanted to show was Waypoint Optimization. So here we have a whole bunch of points on the map, and if we were to simply calculate the route between them, we see we get this pretty intense route, if we scroll down a little bit.
So that's just in the order that the person threw them in there?
Right. And so the total distance is about 144 kilometers to do all this route in the order that the pins were provided. Now if we do that same thing, but we turn on the optimization, we're nearly 50 kilometers shorter on the route, and it looks a lot cleaner as well when you look ahead at the map.
Oh, okay. So you're starting at pin zero.
Yeah. And we're going from 0 to 5 to 1 to 2 to 4.
Cutting
and so
it by 30%+.
Correct.
Saving money, saving gas, saving time.
Correct.
That's fantastic. And all of this stuff is available in the Azure Maps API. We can go and sign up in the Azure portal and start integrating this today.
Correct.
Fantastic. I am learning all about the complexities of routing and finally getting able to use the traveling salesman algorithm after university today on Azure Friday.